Welcome back to the channel. This is The Buzz. Today, we'll be talking about helicopter carriers. And as we all know, helicopter carriers are vital amphibious assault ships that are designed for power projection, troop transport, and air support. So without further ado, let's look at the top 10 helicopter carriers of the world. The top 10 helicopter carriers in the world include advanced vessels from major naval powers, each equipped to carry helicopters and, in some cases, vertical and short takeoff and landing jets. We rank the helicopter carriers based on capacity, technological advancement, propulsion, armament, and overall capabilities. Number 10, the Nam Atlantico A140. This is the flagship of the Brazilian Navy and serves as an amphibious helicopter carrier. She displaces 21,578 tons, measures 203.43 meters in length, and has a range of 8,000 nautical miles. Powered by two Crossley Pilstick PC-2 Mark 6 MW engines, she cruises at 10 knots and can reach a top speed of 18 knots. Her armament includes four 30mm DS-30M Mark II guns, four miniguns, and eight general-purpose machine guns, providing close-in defense. The flight deck supports up to 18 helicopters, including EC-725 Caracal, S-70B Seahawk, and AS-350 Icarol, enhancing her amphibious and anti-submarine capabilities. Additionally, she can carry 40 vehicles and accommodate 830 troops, making her a key asset for expeditionary and humanitarian missions. Number 9, the Doctor Class. The class is a landing platform helicopter and amphibious assault ship operated by the Republic of Korea Navy. It is 199 meters, 653 feet long, with a displacement of 18,000 tons, full load, incorporating stealth technologies. It can carry 720 Marines, 300 plus crew, 10 tanks, 10 trucks, 7 AAVs, 3 field artillery pieces, and 2 LCAC hovercraft. The aircraft hangar accommodates 10 helicopters, but up to 15 helicopters can be carried on the flight deck. Supported aircraft include UH-1H, UH-60P and Super Lynx helicopters, and the deck can support VTOL jets. The self-defense armament includes the REM-116 rolling airframe missile system and the Goalkeeper CIWS, while LPH-6112 is equipped with 4 KVLS cells. Number 8, the Mistral class. The class is a landing helicopter dock, built by France, also referred to as projection and command ships. The class can transport and deploy 16 NH-90 or Tiger helicopters, 4 landing craft, 70 vehicles, including 13 Leclerc tanks or a 40-strong Leclerc tank battalion, along with 450 soldiers. The armament includes Simbad missile systems, 20mm Model F2 guns, 30mm Breda Mauser guns, 7.62mm M134 miniguns, and 12.7mm M2HB machine guns. It has a displacement of 21,500 tons full load, with a length of 199 meter, 653 feet. The propulsion includes two Rolls-Royce Mermaid azimuth thrusters and two 5-bladed propellers, allowing a speed of 18.8 knots, 35 km per hour. Number 7, the Hyuga class. The class is a helicopter carrier of the Japan Maritime Self-Defense Force, comparable to a light aircraft carrier. The ships have enhanced command and control capabilities, allowing them to serve as flagships. They are armed with 16-cell VLS for evolved sea sparrow missiles and Phalanx CIWS for self-defense. The class has a displacement of 19,000 tons full load, with a length of 197 meter, 646 feet. The class can reach speeds of over 30 knots. The flight deck supports 3 SH-60K and 1 MCH-101 helicopters normally, with a maximum capacity of 18 aircraft. Number 7, the Type 075 Yushin class. The class is a landing helicopter dock class built for the People's Liberation Army Navy by Hudong Zhonghua Shipbuilding. It features a full-length flight deck for helicopter operations and a well deck for launching hovercraft and armored amphibious vehicles. The lead ship, Hainan, was commissioned on 23rd April 2021. It has a maximum displacement of 40,000 tons and a full length of 232 meters, 761 feet. The ship can carry 60 armored fighting vehicles and 800 troops for amphibious assault ships. The armament includes 2 HPJ, 14 30mm CIWS, and 2 HQ-10 SAM launchers for defense. The flight deck accommodates up to 28 helicopters. Number 5, the Canberra class. The class consists of 2 landing helicopter dock ships operated by the Royal Australian Navy. The first ship, HMS Canberra, was commissioned in November 2014. They are the largest ships in RAN history, with a full load displacement of 27,500 tons and a length of 230.82 meter or 757 feet. Propulsion includes integrated electric propulsion with 2 Siemens Navantia azimuth thrusters, achieving over 20 knots. The armament consists of 4-to-file Typhoon 25mm remote weapons systems and 6x12.7mm machine guns. The standard aircraft's load is 8 helicopters, but the hangar can accommodate up to 18. They support amphibious operations, disaster relief, and force projection. Number 4, the Juan Carlos I class. This is a multi-purpose aircraft carrier and landing helicopter dock in the Spanish Navy. The class features a ski jump for short takeoff and vertical landing aircraft like the AV-8B Harrier II and F-35B Lightning II. The flight deck has 8 landing spots for various aircraft and can carry 30 helicopters or 10 to 12 fighter plus 10 to 12 helicopters. The class has a displacement of 26,000 tons and a length of 230.82 meters or 757 feet. They are capable of reaching speeds of up to 21 knots, 39 km per hour. And for defense, she has 4 RWS Sentinel 2.0 systems, 12.7mm machine guns, and provisions for BPDMS and VLS. The ship supports amphibious, air, and maritime operations. Number 3 is Zumo class. These are helicopter destroyers serving in the Japan Maritime Self-Defense Force. They are the largest surface combatants in JMSDF, surpassing the Hyuga class. The lead ship entered service in 2015. The Izuma class has a displacement of 26,000 tons full load with a length of 248 meters, 814 feet. It is powered by a Kogak system driving 2 shafts. The ships can reach speeds of 30 knots, and each ship can carry 28 aircraft, including 7 ASW helicopters, 2 SAR helicopters, and 12 plus F-35B. They lack a ski jump or catapult, meaning they rely on V-stall aircraft. For defense, they are armed with 2 Phalanx CIWS and 2 CRAM systems. They serve as multi-role platforms for air and maritime operations. Their design aligns with Japan's expanding regional security role. Number 2, the Wasp class. The Wasp class landing helicopter dock ship serve as amphibious assault ships for the US Navy. They are based on the Tarawa class but modified for advanced aircraft and landing craft. Each ship is capable of transporting almost the full strength of a United States Marine Corps expeditionary unit and landing them in hostile territory via landing craft or helicopters. They provide air support using AV-8B Harrier IIs or F-35B Lightning IIs. The class has a displacement of 40,500 long tons and a length of 831 feet or 253.2 meters. Most ships have 2 steam boilers and geared turbines producing 70,000 horsepower. They achieve speeds of 22 knots and have a range of 9,500 nautical miles. Armament includes RIM-7 Sea Sparrow, RIM-116 Ram, Phalanx CIWS, Mark 38 chain guns, and 50 caliber machine guns. Number 1, the America class LHA. The US America class amphibious assault ships LHA are designed for marine expeditionary units using helicopters and MV-22B Osprey aircraft. They also support AV-8B Harrier II and F-35B Lightning II V-stall jets, along with various attack helicopters. The first of the ship was commissioned in 2014 by the US Navy, with a displacement of 45,000 long tons. They are similar in size to some fixed-wing aircraft carriers. Their length is 844 feet or 257 meters. They can be used as small aircraft carriers carrying 20 to 25 AV-8Bs or F-35Bs. The class features 2 gas turbines and 2 auxiliary propulsion engines, 5,000 horsepower each. Their top speed exceeds 20 knots. They are armed with rolling airframe missile launchers, evolved Sea Sparrow missile launchers, and Phalanx CIWS for defense. They also feature machine guns for close-range range protection. The USS America LHA-6 was the first in the series, with more ships planned. Future variants may incorporate a well deck for amphibious operations. And with this, we've come to the end of today's video. But before you leave, don't forget to hit that notification and subscription button, and we'll see you guys again in our next video. Bye-bye.